Go.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Veronica Slack, and welcome to Recovery Journal class here at the Eastgate Town Center. Every Wednesday, 6 to 7 o'clock, we will be journaling cover to cover in Journal Volume 1, and tonight is Day 1. And the title of tonight's daily meditation is Gratitude for People. So here we have empty boards, we have an empty class. In a little bit here, class will start, and we'll see what comes up on the boards that might help you in your walk with life this week. All right, see you in a bit.
Okay, just so that you know, you weren't in here, this is being filmed, so, because it goes out. Okay, just so that you're aware.
You can work machine.
Okay, so we're going to get started. My name is Veronica Slack. I'm the author of a participating book series that provides creative long-term recovery support for any person with any issue. The series invites the reader to co-write the daily meditations that promote better thinking in a journal form. And the end result is that each person creates a one-of-a-kind book series of their very own, of their own story. So this class, so I'm going to just do like a little 5-minute orientation to bring you up to speed so that you understand what we're doing here in the class. So the books are available on the website or through here. In this class in particular, I'm providing, you don't have to get the book. The class is free, and if you want to grab one of them packets right there in front of you, okay, this is what we're doing today. Every day, every week, we do the same format. We will go through basically 4 pages of the journal. It'll be like day one, like today will be day one, my page of thoughts, and then artwork. And it's always that format. It'll just be different content, okay? So it doesn't matter if you don't come to class for 3 weeks. If you come back, we'll always be doing the same thing. So I'll tell you more about that in a minute. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through the journal quickly in 5 minutes, less than 5 minutes. So the journals, they all start off the same way. Well, you have journals and then you have book one visuals, but I'm not going to go into the whole series right now. This is the book that we're working with, Journal Volume 1, and they all start off the same way with about the author, how to use the books, the table of contents, and the introduction. And then you're going to come to a page like this. I'll kind of walk over here so you can see that. Okay, and on this page, this is called the page of dedication. And on this page is where we begin to write the books together, where you begin to participate. I dedicated it to who I chose, and you'll dedicate it to who you choose. There's space right there. At the bottom of this page, in every book, you will see this statement, and it reads, "The Participating Book Series is designed to encompass all economic classes, all genders, all cultures, all races, and all beliefs. And this occurs by you either participating in a class activity or writing the other half of the book according to your own view." Yeah. So now, when you turn the page, it starts off like we're going to do. Day one, each day is a 2-page day. It starts off with day one on this, which would be your left. The thought is framed from 2 sides by the title and then to draw you in. And then you read the thought, you ponder it, and then just below it, it prompts you to relate, comment, or add to the thought, and it gives you space to do that right here. At the bottom of this page, there's 1 or 2 questions that promote better thinking. Now, at the top of the next page, which is not that, that's my notes, it's night, you'll see this page. This is the same right side throughout the whole entire book as well. This is called My Page of Thoughts, and this is totally your page. Where you're writing the other complete half. It starts off with, this is on my mind today. Then it said, you can look on the one page here, on the back of this second page that I gave you, you'll see the page I'm talking about right now. Okay, so on that page it says, this is on my mind today. Turn the next page, Robin. Yes, that one. Okay, and then it says, this is the solution. If needed, this is the solution today. Below that, this is how I feel today. And then it gives you space to add how you feel, and it gives you a feelings chart. There are two alternate feelings charts that alternate throughout the book. So you circle as many as you want, and there's always a positive and a negative next to each other. Then below that in this journal is the 3x3 daily planner for time management, keeping it really simple. Three things in the morning, three things in the evening, in the afternoon, and three things in the evening. And then below that, my personal note to my higher power, and you put there whatever it is that you like. As you continue through the book, you're going to come across pages that look like this. This is the other page that you have there. These are called the black tab pages, and these are throughout the journal. And on these pages, these are for your creative inspirations. Okay, they can also be found in the table of contents. You put your artwork here, you doodle here, some days when you just don't feel like writing. Maybe you want to write a song, maybe you want to write a poem. That belongs here, anything you can think of. Maybe someone gave you something inspirational and you want to take that in there. Okay, it's your book, you build it. So now, as you come to the back page, as you finish journaling through, you come to the back page, you'll see a page like this. Not like that, like this. And this is called the page of completion. Once you have finished all the way through, this, you will sign your name. It says, congratulations on your achievement from the heart. And then it encourages you to take it, put it in a special place, and go on to the next volume. And here you have in your hands a combined effort of a book that you've co-written. And then you build the series. And when you finish the series, everything that you see that the author has, which is many, you have as well. Okay, so now I've told you, you'll do this at home. So what is the class? So the class, recovery journal class, is support while people are journaling, but it's a little bit more than that. What we're going to do is, we're going to be bringing the book to life, okay? Because we're going to, just like you make it, you're creating a book at home, but when you come to class, we're going to create day one, okay? So that's going to be one page in the book of this class. So when we get to the end, it'll be a complete book. So what happens is, we will answer the questions and they'll be fast. It's a real fast-paced class, okay? And then as we move through, we will come to these pages, and what happens on these pages, which I'll tell you more about later, is you have two pages for a reason. One page, whatever you put, you'll pick something inspirational from class, a word or a drawing. You'll pick a flower, a smiley face, something inspirational. Because what you're going to do with it is, whatever you put on one page, you mirror on the other page, meaning you do the exact same thing. At the top of the page, you'll put your name and the date, just your first name, not your last name. And then when you're done, at the end of class, you're going to give me one, and you're going to keep one. And the one you give me will go inside one of the books that somebody buys anonymously. So when they get the book, wherever they're at, you just trust that a higher power has that message that they need it to see. Hmm. So, and every class, we do the same thing. So every time you come to class, you're making one and you're giving. So you give and you receive in this class. Then, when we're done, we've built these boards from all different walks of life. Everybody has different answers. I want the answers that come from your heart and fast. And when we get them and we push them out through Facebook, through YouTube, you don't
makes
know.
More people think the same way.
You never know who needs to see that. Whatever is on the boards, like I've been posting them from the other treatment where I'm at, and it's just you never know who is who's meant to see them. So. Hello. Hi. Hello. You just missed the orientation, but it's okay. Come on in, sit down. No, it's all right. He'll catch on. So that's pretty much how that's going to work. So once we get done, we'll take the boards and we'll, you can go go up on YouTube. They'll probably be up there this evening, possibly, or tomorrow. If you want to just take one of these here. Oh, you know what? I didn't bring my extra pens. That is not good. I think I might have it. Yeah, we can get him a pen.
I usually carry a pen.
I got one. I got one.
In his pocket, not today.
Okay. Okay, so does anybody have any questions quickly before we get started? Okay, so that's how things are going to go. So today is day one, and we're going to start our boards now. So first thing that we're going to do today is we're going to define, I want your definition of the word. Wait a minute, let me read the thought. Let me back up here a second. Okay, so here's the thought. The name of it is Gratitude for People, Day One. I opened this book to an empty page, and then I thought of you, the other people on this spinning world. I could not leave it empty, for every day you have helped me to not have empty meaning to my existence. To you I say, you are the best thing that ever happened to me and the hardest thing for me to love without condition, though I am not ever giving up hope that this is possible for me. So now quickly, before we start, did a word pop out? Did something make you, a thought, something from what I just read while I was reading? Did it make you think of something?
Brother.
What was it?
Brother.
Brother? Yes. I want words, people. Okay, it made you think of your brother. What else?
Caseworker.
Caseworker?
Yeah.
Did it make you, anybody think of anything else? Something personal from when you were a child? Anything? Something?
Pain.
What was it?
Pain.
Yes. Please, I wanted what's really there, just spit it out. What else? Anything else? Can we get one more thing that somebody thought? I opened this book to an empty page, and I thought of you, the other people on this spinning world. I could not leave it empty, for every day you have helped me to not have empty meaning to my existence.
A word from my childhood was abandoned.
Abandoned? It could be two words. It could be a short sentence. Says it's continued survival.
Hmm.
Right? What do you say the word existence means to you? What does that word mean? People have different meanings in dictionaries.
I think it's about like realizing that you're a person that affects other people. You may not realize how you're affecting people at the time, but it always, everything you do is always affecting somebody.
All right, realizing you're affecting. Is that what you said?
Yeah. You affect other people.
You're affecting others. Okay. What else does it mean to someone?
A constant state of being.
Constant state of being.
Living life.
Living life? Start answering the question. We're going to put a list out here. Why is it important to think of other people in this world?
I think consciousness is like being aware that you can't survive without other consciousnesses.
All right, so we'll say be aware you can't survive without others.
Yeah.
Be aware.
We were put here to serve others.
What was that?
We were put here to serve others.
to appreciate what they do for you.
Yes. I'll fix my phone. What they do for you? Okay, what about, don't think the world revolves around us. How about that?
That works.
Maybe so that you can do something that someone else appreciates.
You can be more compassionate.
The world. What was that last one? You can get in a couple words.
What was that?
Be compassionate.
Be compassionate. If you understand.
Yeah, yeah, that's very good. We'll just go him up there with you. To be compassionate or to learn to be, what is it?
To be.
To be.
To be more compassionate.
To be more. Okay. All right, list the times I felt empty meaning.
Divorce.
It can be all the way from a kid all the way up to through today. When have you felt empty meaning?
Last 6 years.
What was it? Can you say one?
The last 6 years. That's what it means to me. No,
okay, that's good. Last 6 years.
Death of my father. The reason I said it, I was 11. So that was,
huh?
I was 11 when that happened, so it was. So a lot of things other than just emptiness.
Mm-hmm. I have experienced it when there wasn't nothing wrong at all. Mm-hmm.
That's where the word abandon came from.
Sometimes in life is your thing. Okay. List what is hard about loving other people. Dealing with their stuff and our stuff, right?
Having their feelings attached to theirs.
What's that? What'd you say?
Having your feelings attached to theirs.
Being empathetic and understanding someone else's situation.
Mm-hmm. We don't love ourselves. We don't love ourselves first.
Yeah. Warm, unfortunately, that air is not working.
No, it's not.
And probably going into the summer, it's gonna be even more.
Yeah, just wait.
Okay, on this book, in this page, in the journal, the bottom of your page there, of that thought here, there's the basic question. So it says, Miss, who or what is giving you meaning, hope, or purpose in life right now? Just throw names out there, anything that you want. What's giving you meaning? Who or what?
Granddaughter.
Who?
Grandkids.
Grandkids? Who else? What else?
My son.
Your son? Anybody have animals?
Yeah, but it's a cat.
Well, I could say a higher power.
Yes.
And
learning from strangers.
Oh, yes. Very, very good. That's a good one right there.
Wisdom.
Cat or dog. What was that from?
Wisdom.
Wisdom.
Is it longer?
Is there a friend that you, anybody that a friend has given you? I mean, who gives us meaning? What gives us meaning? It could be a book. It could be a TV show. But it has to come from you. Okay, all right, well, we'll just move on to how can I show that I am not giving up hope?
Working through the pain.
On people, places, and things. So what was that you said?
Working through the pain.
Okay, how can I show? Think about this in your heart. How can you show that you're not giving up hope on people? Take time to listen to them.
Mm-hmm.
Try to get two more things with people. How can I show I'm not giving hope? Giving up hope on people. Giving up hope.
Go participate.
What was that?
Go participate.
You could cut them a break. You cut people a break. We can maybe be there for them. Okay. And what is a place?
Take time to enjoy it.
What was that?
Take time to enjoy it. Stop and smell the flowers.
So when we think about places, not to give up hope on, like, I'm just going to throw out there ghettos in our cities and a lot of places. We don't want to give up on places where people are.
11th Avenue.
11th Avenue. You want to say our judicial system?
That's true, Jay.
Mm-hmm. and take care of what I didn't have.
Is that the same as appreciating what you have?
Mm-hmm. And sometimes we have a lot of things, and we don't appreciate the things that we have because we're always trying to get something else. Okay, so on the other page, I don't know if you can see this here, I'll pull this over. On the other page, this is my page of thoughts. And on this page, this is where I woke up with. Usually what we'll do is we won't have enough time to go through the whole page because we're going to get into drawing in about a little bit here. So each week what will happen is I'll go through a couple of the things, and then like next week it'll be the feelings, and then the following week it'll be the 3x3, and then it'll just keep rotating. This week is going to be on my mind. So when you're at home doing this by yourself, it's whatever you want to put there. For class, I want to think about this morning. We all woke up. Something was on our mind. So what was something that was on your mind this morning when you woke up? And then we'll get the solution to it after we say what's on our mind.
My situation, I didn't wake up, but my brother was heavily on my mind.
Okay. Brother hospitalized, right?
Yes.
Okay, that's one thing. Somebody else woke up with something on their mind, in trouble, so you woke up, it was like, Bill, or it was something, missing somebody, or maybe home across the ocean.
I wake up every morning and I think about how can I make the machine running, because I'm here for business.
Okay, all right, so on my mind was work.
Yeah.
Work, is it work or is it work? Because work is like steady, like, all right, so work on my mind. So working hard?
Not hard, but it's sometimes good luck, sometimes bad luck. I don't know what really happens. I fight and
okay.
We celebrate or we lose.
Find inspiration.
He sounds like he's from Alabama, too.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll get down there to that solution in a minute. So what else? Did somebody say something else?
That's what's on my mind today, is just finding that inspiration. Because like
I've
been riding my bike like crazy, and I've just been trying to find hills to go up lately.
Finding inspiration.
Okay. What about you?
What did you wake up with? Anything today on your mind?
Anxiety about the future.
Okay, that's excellent. Playing
in the cat box. I hate that.
About the future. All right, so let's talk about some solutions for the first one here. I'll label them 2, 3, 4, 5. I'll come back here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, so brother is in the hospital.
Prayer.
What could be a solution?
Prayer.
Prayer. And of course, you visited him, right? That's a solution. Prayer, visit.
Yes.
Anybody else have a solution for him? With a family member that's hospitalized, make sure you take care of yourself because he mentioned he did not sleep. Okay, so the solution is definitely to take care of yourself.
Communication.
Okay, and then for working. Okay, so it's on your mind working.
Have at it.
Being proud of what you know people see you do.
There you go.
Not always.
Yeah.
What part of Alabama are you from?
I'm from Germany.
Okay, and okay, finding inspiration. What is the solution for that? Open your mind to other things?
This class.
Keep it so hard in there, open your heart.
What about anxiety? What's a solution?
Meditation.
Anxiety about the future.
Meditation.
Refocus.
Don't run.
Be one. I like that.
So before we go to this last one, let's take a look at gratitude for people. I mean, we're talking about why it's important to think of other people, to be aware that we can't survive without others, the list of empty meaning in my life, and we received divorce the last 6 years, and it was hard about loving other people, dealing with their stuff. We don't love ourselves first. So from this, if we could just get some positive something to put in this box, an idea of gratitude for people, and then look at this one, who, what's giving us meaning, cats, dogs, wisdom, higher power, grandkids, and how can I show that I'm not giving up hope for working through the pain, taking time to listen. Does anybody get a phrase or something that comes to mind? I know one thing that really stuck out to me. Where was it? What was your name?
My name's Aaron.
Aaron. It was something that Aaron said. Where was that on there where he said about strangers?
Learning from strangers?
Yeah. That was something that stuck out for me today. Did anything stick out for anybody else? A phrase or something from this board? Let's get something. Gratitude for people.
What's coming to my mind is treat people the way you want to be treated or doing to others.
How you want to be treated?
Yes.
Yeah.
That's my secret to life. That's my secret to life.
Gratitude there. Okay. So, my personal note to my higher power. During the class, what's our personal note to our higher power today?
Express it.
Express it?
Express it.
Thanks for another day.
There you go. I'm going to say, you're awesome. That's some gratitude.
Yeah.
Anybody else got something they want to throw on that board?
Thanks for the fire.
Thank you.
Thanks for what?
Thanks for the fire.
All right. Now we're going to take the crayons, markers.
I'll bring some more over to you. You can pick some out of here. And now if you'll take, you didn't hear this. If you'll take these two pages, and what you're going to do is this one here.
first name only on the top and today's date, and then whatever you put on this page, you make identical on this page. It could be a flower, it could be a word, something inspirational. And then you're drawing it, and then you're going to color it in, and then you're going to give me one when you're done, and I'm going to put it in the book that somebody buys. So
what do you mean, are you both like?
Yeah, because you want me to keep identical. So if you put a frog here, you put a frog here. If you put a pink frog here, you put a pink frog here. If you put the word love here, you put the word love here. So in other words, whatever you're going to keep one for you, and then you're going to give me one, and I'm going to put it in the book, and then somebody anonymous, you're going to put the first name and the date, not your guys' name.
Mm-hmm.
And then somebody will buy the book, and then they'll get something inspirational from you.
Mm-hmm.
So everybody goes out, everybody has crayons, markers, that's yours. And here's more pencils. If you want pencils, markers, I'm going to get something to draw too. You need crayons?
Oh, yeah, I'm sure.
Here.
Thank you. I'm glad they put the color on there. I'm colorblind.
Huh?
I said, I'm glad they put the color on there. I'm colorblind.
Our page for today, of our day one page. You said I didn't put day one up there.
You said two pages. Where is the other page?
He's on it. Look. You got this one here.
Oh.
No, it's on the back side of that one. This
right.
One you're going to keep.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so put your...
I'm so confused.
Yeah, so whatever you're drawing on this one, you got to draw on that. But put your name up here, Robin.
Okay.
And the date. And then take a picture of the boards. And you can do whatever you want with it as well. There it goes. This was the one. This was the jewel that I saw from this one right here. This was the other one out of this one.
Mm-hmm.
What do you do?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. How can I show that I'm not giving up to it? Working through the pain was an excellent one. And
what is that pain? Is physical or mental? How long did it take you to think this up? This, you're genius. This is so cool.
So now, next week it'll be day two. And if you at some point want to get a recovery journal, you can either get the 31-day recovery journal, which is the smaller one, or the volume one. And what that is this smaller one is 31 days of the bigger one. So this is long term, this is short term. This one's $14.99, this one is $29.99. But this one is the one we're going to in class, the big one. So it may take us probably it can anywhere over a year or two.
How much did you say the volume one was?
$29.99. But it'll be there every week and we can get it through the website.
Okay.
Very nice. I'm going to take a picture of that.
I wrote it the landlord that years and years and years ago.
You could have put your name on.
Put my name on it?
Well, just your first name, not your last name. Just put your name. Did you put yours, Robin? Yeah, on the date. The year. Put the year. Somebody's going to get that.
Oh, I don't have to say it, but I don't know how to do it.
I can't tell you how many stick people that I have. You can put that on board.
Give me one copy of it, don't you? Not two.
Yeah, yeah, only one. Yeah.
Okay. I'm curious. Here's mine. I want to see yours.
That's the Mountain Stew.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Did you hear Mountain Stew?
There.
No, she's from Alabama. I said, it sounds like you from Alabama.
I love
America.
It's good. But people in Alabama, I don't understand.
Oh,
many.
Yeah. It's a joke, bad joke.
It's okay.
Just cooling off in here.
Yeah, finally.
Finally.
The idea is that we give to ourselves the same way that we give to somebody else. That we give, and then you can look at it as you give back what's been given to you.
It's in yours. Huh.
That's what was on my mind. That's what came out.
That's good.
All right.
That's what made you make the whole books and everything?
What?
Thinking that, you know, you give what you get what you give.
No, well, I wrote the books over the course of the last 18 years. So I've been in recovery for my anniversary. My 27th anniversary is this Friday.
Wow.
So, yeah.
Actually, when I was coming over here, I went to TCCS. I think that's what it's called. Because I saw a bunch of people hanging out there. But, like, they don't know about this class. And I guess, like, that's a state thing. And people kind of go through that sometimes. To come to something like this, you've got to kind of, like, just realize that you want to do something.
This class will grow.
Yeah.
I've been journaling, like writing just down my own thoughts, but this is really cool to have like a way to really like categorize it and express it, because I never went to school for anything like that. I don't really know how to put it together, you know? This is a really good way to put it together.
Yeah.
Well, I think the thing is, through the years, when I originally wrote that first little book there in the late 90s, and then through the years I kept writing and staying in recovery and doing things, and then in 2015 I revised it, and then I divided it into the volumes, and then I thought about all my years in recovery, and I picked the things that helped me, and I built them into the recovery journals, and I launched the series in November 2017 from Eagleville Hospital in Pennsylvania. That was the rehab that I went through 27 years ago. So now I do the class. class down at the volunteer treatment center. I do this class. And but I just wanted to bring it out into the public, and I'm like, well, and then from the public, I want to push it out and just let it grow, and you know, it's a neat project. So that's it. That's class this week, guys. Yep, glad everybody came, and it's Veronica.
Robin.
Terry.
Aaron.
What was your name again?
My name is Terry.
Terry. And what was your name?
Aurora.
Mm-hmm. That's a pretty name. And
I have also a pretty name. My name is Dan.
What is it?
Dan.
Ben?
Yep, Dan.
It's very different.
So, Rob?
Dan. Okay, so most times people abroad they call me Benowitz. I think it's easy though.
We'll call you Fred.
That's a popular name.
My name's not.
It's, it's hard to roll the R like that, the way that we were talking.
Yeah, I know. I know.
Yeah, it's really hard for us to roll the R like that.
And okay. Susan?
Susan.
Yeah, well, you're going back to Germany?
Yeah, I don't know when we talked about it today. No idea.
How long have you been here?
I'm already here since May 27th. And it was planned to go to fly back next week on Tuesday, but not sure.
Where'd you go? Soccer. Yes? Did you draw one for you?
I need to take a picture from this one.
Okay. And what one are you giving me? Can you draw one for
yourself? Yeah, I wrote some stuff on this one.
Yeah, well, okay. You gotta draw the same. Yeah. So
oh,
that
I'll probably
one,
draw this tonight.
Well,
that's kind of
well next time you come to class,
yeah.
You have to do.
I have to do a mirror?
Yeah.
Press it on here really hard?
No, you have to draw it.
I gotta draw two of them. I took all my time drawing one. I can draw another.
Oh, that's what
I can
yeah,
sit here
yeah,
and draw all day.
Yes, you can draw
it.
You
got
can draw
me.
It right now. This,
okay.
Is what, this is what you do. Because the idea is, Aaron, that you do for yourself the same for somebody else.
This drawing is what I did today, though, so I already did it once. This
no.
is my second one. I just kind of made the day and then drew about it.
No.
Thank you. I will have my own pen.
See this?
Oh, that's
looks
like
this. Identical. So this should look like this. And even though you did another picture, this has to be the same picture. So somebody in the world is going to get this picture.
And I know what I left them.
Yeah. And then each week, as you're sending out one, you're building these two.
Okay,
and then you're
so
going to
have
your own little portfolio. So you got to draw it.
I don't know. I kind of just want to send it.
Is that Yogi or Boo Boo?
Send it. What do you, yeah, but you still
know
you don't have one.
I think it's Yogi.
All right. I'm not gonna, are you going to get a book? Yeah.
This is so cool.
Are you want the big volume. You want the big volume.
I do.
Well, you do because you're going to go through. This is the shorter version.
Yeah, I'm just going to show them what we're doing. So that it
okay.
Be
Aurora.
Interesting. I mean,
okay.
It's
Aurora.
Aurora.
Do
you want
a
book?
It's really small and different now.
Oh, yeah,
to
it's like.
Show
it's,
them.
Yeah.
Well, this class is terrible. It's genius. This came from the heart, I know.
Yep. The Aurora Boreal.
All right, no, you can get going. I'll lock up the room and everything, so we're good.
Yeah.
Oh, sure. I really?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
I don't want to show them. Yeah. Wow, I'm excited about
perfect.
It.
Yep. And you can take your brother in the hospital a book because it's for you know people who are in hospital, not just for
everything.
Always. Everyone has their own struggles.
That's what we're going to do. I'll have to remember that for next week.
How long did you say you wrote this?
Over the last 18 years.
Yeah, this, I mean, I won't say
yep.
genius, but it is a wonderful concept. I'm excited now. I was excited to begin with, but now I see what it is. Very nice to meet everyone. I hope, is it next week?
Yep.
Next Wednesday?
Next Wednesday?
Next Wednesday, every Wednesday. Yep.
Hope to see y'all next Wednesday. Thank you.
All right, you have a good week, Robin.
Call me if you need me.
I will.
Can you do it?
Yep.
Bye. Yeah, I got the other day that this picture.
Okay, so I just got them too. I didn't draw two, so two is the one with the first one, but I did take a picture of both sides with my phone.
Okay, that's fine.
I'm bad at making copies. I can handle the mirror, but I can't make copies.
Okay. All right, you guys. What's that say? Be kind always. Very nice. For everyone, they're... Yes, very good. Somebody will be happy to get that. All right.
The art is on you.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you guys for coming.
Thank you.
Hope to see you again. Did you give me your paper? Yes, you gave it to me already.
The picture, yeah.
Okay.
It was really hard to make the picture. And when I was in school, yeah. We had a teacher. I told her, you don't see it, it's a wolf. Mm. You can see there's no neck chain, no, yeah, no chain is not fixed, no dog house.
Exactly.
And mountains in the background. He told my grandma.
Granted, the mountains eventually.
Yeah. Okay.
All right.
So,
good night, everybody. Here we have the boards. Class is over, and today in class, we talked about gratitude for others. We started off by talking about why is it important to think of what other people think in this world, and why think of other people in this world. So the things that we talked about was to be aware that we can't survive without others, and to appreciate what they do for you, as well as we listed times that we felt empty meaning in life. So some of the things that we talked about was when felt empty meaning, when there wasn't anything wrong at all. That was a highlight. And then we listed what's hard about loving others. And one of the things was having to have your feelings attached to theirs and being empathetic and understanding someone else's situation. So then we talked about list why or what was giving you meaning or hope in your life. So from that, one of the highlights was learning from strangers and how can I show that I'm not giving up hope. And the one thing that had stood out in class was working through the pain. So now, places not to give up on was don't give up on the ghettos, don't give up on our judicial system. And then we came over here, and this was on my mind today. So on my mind today was someone's brother was hospitalized and finding inspiration and anxiety about the future. And our solutions to that was for a brother that's hospitalized was, for prayer, to pray, and to make sure you take care of yourself. And then the other thing for finding inspiration, it was the person said, come to this class and open your mind with others. And what else? For anxiety about the future, we came up with as a class to refocus, meditation, and don't run and talk to a friend. So here you have it. This was our boards from today. And I hope that you find something that will help you in your walk of life from them. All right, till next week.